Hello, my name is Ebony Rogers and I'm an EduSerc Young Innovator. I would like to share with you an exciting event that's coming here to the Baltimore Convention Center. It's the annual High School Development Conference.
At the age of 15, a young man in high school discovered his talents of teaching and mentoring when he was allowed a 5-minute opportunity to teach his geometry class when no one else in the class could understand the concepts of what the teacher was teaching. His initial success in reaching his classmates sparked a passion in his young heart of Brian K. Smith.
So often, young people are not given the opportunity to express how they really feel. And so I always like to hear how young people feel because it teaches me. And then I can carry the message to other folks as well.
To be honest, I want to encourage the presenters of this conference that we've been to Dallas, Texas. We've been to one in Alexandria. And out of all the conferences, this was the best one. It was really put together well. It was geared toward the students in the high school level from 9th to 12th grade. When you go to the larger conferences, they sort of leave out the children that need to be prepped for the colleges, and they just pay attention to the collegiate students. And that's one failure in all the conferences that I've been in. So to get more high school students to come here so they can be prepped for college, to be able to speak out, to be vocal, to dress nice, to know what they're supposed to do in interviews, this is the best information that I've received. Plus, I got something from the leadership conference myself to take back on my job. So when I decide to go on an interview, I have some skills that I can throw at them and know I'm gonna be ready.
The beauty of education and what it does is it causes your mind to be able to think at a different level. In other words, you can become a critical thinker. You can make decisions that's gonna help you accomplish your dreams and goals. And that's the beauty of education.
In this particular situation, you have one forum where everybody comes together and you just have to walk around for 2 days and you can get knowledge that took me years.
This has just been a great day. So, yes, it's been a positive 2 days and, you know, the conference, the information, it was an overwhelming amount of information. And perhaps maybe some of the slots weren't attended, but it's not because they weren't wanted to be. You know, you didn't want to go to them. You just didn't have enough time to do everything that you wanted to do, but what you got was excellent. You know, for the parents, for the students, you can tell just from observing through the workshops and the conferences, each and every person here will walk away with something, and way over more than $20 worth. And, you know, you can't just express how great of a job the two sponsors have done, you know, and getting people to come out to support, to give kids and parents and teachers information, and it's, you know, it's just really good.
You get knowledge that took me years, and a lot of people in this office, in this room here, years to obtain in a couple of days. And that's one of the things that I really see about this, and it's unfortunate that a lot of other schools aren't making this mandatory. I mean, I know that there's, I've heard that the people who sponsored it, who put this together, actually went out and tried to get the word out to a lot of the schools. But over in PG County, where I'm at, there is a lot of students there that should be here. And I think that this is a good opportunity for them to get here, and I think that they need to, I know that they've been out there doing that, but the teachers and the principals and all those people are doing their kids a disservice for not being here, not sending their kids here.
Well, the conference is great. I think it's helping with these students because it gives students understanding that they can actually play a role, a significant role in society. And if they just use their leadership potential, and more than just potential, if they put their leadership potential into action, so that way they can become working leaders, then they can start to see some of the changes that they want to see, whether it's in their neighborhoods, communities, households, how people may perceive them. But the conference is just the starting point.
I think the conference is very, very excellent for young people to come and learn more. Like we just finished the leadership one, and I got a lot of insight on that and how to become a better leader in SGA.
So
I thought it was very good information for young teens to learn about the HIV and how high it is. And I thought it was had very good info.
You've been getting
yes.
Out of the whole program.
Yes, I just came from the college expo, so I was going to there and I was thinking about different colleges I can go to. They have really good colleges over there, so I'm about to, I just got done filling out some information so I can get some mail.
I can take away more. I'm gaining more leadership skills as I go to conference after conference, and I'm really taking in and trying to network so that in my life, eventually, I'm going to have the things necessary that I need to do to fulfill my purpose.
Through partnerships and continued community support, EduSerc strives to host this event in the fall to every metropolitan city in the nation. Let's take a look at how Brian K. Smith started with a vision, but ended up with the dream of a lifetime. The Educator Serving the Community Awards is a special event designed to raise the value of educators in our nation.
We're with Lockheed Martin, and we're here to support any way that we possibly can.
I'm thankful for the nomination. I'm thankful for this opportunity to take this award that's doing something that I love.
Hey, just one generation, two generations, receiving this award for doing something about literacy means a lot.
One of the things that we, even though we're a program, our success has been that we have almost individualized every aspect of the program to the students because their needs are so different.
I think I'm very thankful for the award, but I'm even more grateful for the opportunity to meet Brian Smith and his wife, and not only to come to get an award, but to form a partnership. And I see a vision, and I don't know if Baltimore, Maryland sees it, but we do. And I praise God for it, and I thank God for what I have seen today, even with the youth, and I know for what I've seen tonight. And I think it is a blessing that Brian Smith did something that most people fear to do, and that is to recognize educators. Somehow, no one wants to take that stand. And I am grateful, I'm honored, and I just pray that we will continue to work for our youth and that you all will support him in the effort because it is awesome. Thank you.